Okay, welcome back to my Let's Play of Final Fantasy XIV on the PC. Last time, we liberated Doma, I guess. I mean, we flooded a castle and killed some people. I guess we killed a bunch of people. A lot of people died, including Gosetsu. Probably our good old samurai friend, who you knew was gonna die the moment you set eyes upon him. But life goes on. The world turned upside down. These fucking Hamilton references, goddamn! Somebody on the English translation team really loves Hamilton, or loved it circa 2017. Thank you. The occupation has ended then, and the people must be informed of our victory. But I will not simply give up Gosetsu for lost. Before aught else, we must needs search the ruins.
Allow me, my friends. The castle is still collapsing into the river, and could easily drag you to your deaths. I can navigate the waters easily, without fear of drowning.
Be reasonable, brother. You know he is right. Fang, a word, if I may. My lord withdraws into himself, unable to turn his thoughts from the keep. He needs us now more than ever.
My friends, I am returned. I swam as far into the ruins as I could.
And did you find him?
Nay, lady, naught remained of the keep for me to search. Undermined from below and shaken from above, the manner of its collapse was most unusual. If the floor beneath him gave way before the rest, it is not impossible that he could have been sent tumbling into the river. But the water is thick with slit and debris. Despite my best efforts, I could not find him. I am sorry.
There is naught for which you should apologize. Thank you, Soroban, for taking it upon yourself to search. Castle is in ruins, and the people are eager to learn the fate of their nation. We leave at once. Are you sure, my lord?
The day is won, and the morrow beckons. It falls to us to greet it.
I'm going down to the docks to see if I can't get one of the Confederate ships to take us to the Enclave. Mayhap we should tell the others at the House of the Fierce to gather there. Magni and Sadhu know naught of what happened in the castle. I will go and tell them.
They fought valiantly and with honor, Serena. I pray you tell them that as well. You too, my friend, were instrumental in this triumph. I must insist that you be present when we bring these tidings to my people.
So they pretty much just confirm that Gosetsu's still alive because they didn't find a body. I mean, come on. Come on now.
You all look like shite. Captain thought you might need a ride to the Enclave. Ready to come aboard? On you go then. Sit wherever you like. I don't know what happened in there, but it's over. You won. That's cause enough for celebration. And those people you're about to see need something to celebrate.
We brought everyone here. You were the last to arrive.
I see. Thank you. We owe the Confederacy a great debt. I have waited 25 years for this moment. You owe us naught.
It's Lord Hien!
Lord Hien!
It's him!
He lives! He lives!
Some few words of encouragement would not go amiss, my lord.
Right. Yes, of course.
You're their lord, remember. Stand tall.
Forgive me. This is rather more daunting than I had anticipated. But you are right. I must be strong. Wish me luck. We are a sorry lot, are we not? Tired, dirty, stinking of blood and sweat and ash. The people pushed to the point of breaking. And yet, we won. The perseverance to endure decades of oppression. The will to carry on the legacy of those we have lost. These were the bonds that held us together and gave us the strength to reclaim our home. After 25 hard years, the shadow of the Empire no longer darkens these lands, and we may at last look forward to the dawning of a new day. But, my friends, it will be a day of work. So I ask you, have you yet the strength to stand? To rise up with me once more, here and now, and begin to rebuild our homeland?
Dorma!
This will not end with Dorma. We will see to that, right, Lys?
Right.
Indeed, this is but the beginning. The tide is turning, and it shall soon bear us back across the seas and onward unto the next battlefield.
good. That music hits so good. Oh my god. What more do you want? I wonder if I should have teleported somewhere. Nope. Okay. Are you quite certain you would not prefer to stay a while longer? There are sure to be festivities, at which you would be the guest of honor, like as not. Very well. There are other ways in which we might celebrate. By rejoining the fight for freedom in Garabania, for one. Short though our time here has been, we have all come to regard this land and her people as our own, I think. But we have done that which we came here to do. Word of Doma's liberation will soon spread throughout the Empire, and we must seize this opportunity to rekindle the fires of liberation in the West. We dare not allow the Imperials a moment's respite, lest they march on Doma again. For the sake of all concerned, we should leave immediately. Did I hear you right? You are leaving. I'm afraid so. We've got our own battle to fight. What about you? Will you be heading back to the steppe? Yes, the war here is ended, and there is no cause to remain. The Orinir and Dotharil have already withdrawn. I will follow them anon, but I wish to bid you farewell first.
The Blue, too, must return to their homes. We will be back. Doma has need of merchants and builders, and we are eager to offer our services.
Just like that, our grand fellowship is broken. Without ceremony or pomp, you steal off into the dark. No matter. We have plenty to be getting on with. Places to be, people to rob, and so on. And the captain never was one for mingling.
I am a pirate. Give me a song in the tavern, and I will be happy. Hobnobbing with Lord Hian? Nay.
No taste for the finer things. In any event, we need not part ways here. If you are Fort Kugane, we would be happy to take you. Her waters have always been fruitful. I wish you well in your journey, my friends. May you ever walk in crimson. Thank you, Serena, for everything.
May the Kami speed you on your way. Until we meet again. Naught remains undone. You are ready to depart.
We're ready.
To Kugane, then. Have everything? Good. We will need to weigh anchor before the Sekisagumi arrive. From the bottom of my heart, I thank you for what you did. Give my regards to the Uldan.
Swift and secret departure. I informed Tataru of our coming. She and Hancock should be waiting for us in the Ruby Bazaar. Then it is here we part ways. Best of luck to you and yours in your piratical endeavors, I suppose. All right. Well, yeah, so this Japan only really had one good area. And now we get to go back to Garabania, which is all shit. I'm a little sad about all that. But we did come back with a sweet robe. Welcome back, everyone, and congratulations on a job well done.
It is a pleasure as ever to see your smiling face, Totaro. Less so yours, Hancock, though Rasho and I are sincerely grateful for your assistance.
The pleasure was all mine, Master Alfano, I assure you.
Anyway, you'll be glad to hear that I've already chartered passage for you back to Limsa Lominsa. The ship is to leave port this very day, but the captain has agreed to wait until the four of you have boarded.
The four of us? You mean to stay here in Kugane?
Yes. I gave it some thought, and I realized that even with Doma free, there's still a need for a woman in the middle. Maybe even more than before, considering all the friends and alliances you made.
As I told her many times before, I would be more than willing to assist you.
And as I told you many times before, I am not about to let you worm your way into our affairs and exploit our connections for your personal gain.
Must you always presume the worst?
So there you have it. I will remain here for now. You needn't worry. I'm a regular at the hostelry and a half dozen other local institutions. Everyone loves me. So go, go. Don't let me keep you. Buy your supplies and souvenirs while you still can. When you've finished, make haste to the docks. Pier number 2, to be precise. I'll be waiting for you there.
Alright. Shipping us out real fucking fast. Usetsu's not even cold in the grave. And we're out of here.
Alright. Time is of the essence, I suppose.
First to arrive, as always. Hopefully the others will not be far behind.
Ah, there you are. All packed and ready to go?
To the best of my knowledge, yes. Apologies for the wait. The task of tying up loose ends invariably takes longer than one allows. Happily, however, all now seems to be in order.
Then there's nothing left to do but to board the ship. Do try and enjoy the journey, won't you? It may be your last chance to rest for a while.
That would depend on the good captain's choice of route.
As ever, Totaro, I pray you take all due precautions while making your inquiries. Better to avoid the local authorities altogether than risk a repeat of our Ishgardian episode.
And what sordid episode is this, pray tell?
Naught to speak of, I assure you.
You there! Hold that ship!
What are you two doing here? Shouldn't you be in Doma?
Shouldn't you? You left with nary a word. We half wondered if I had done something to offend.
Upon learning that you had departed for Kugane, we immediately resolved to give chase. Our comrades can manage affairs in our absence, and it seemed the least we could do.
You mean you came all this way just to say goodbye?
That too, aye. But there was something else I felt I had to say. You helped us win our freedom, and for that I cannot thank you enough. Accordingly, after we have established an interim government and so forth, I think it only meet that we repay the favor by dispatching our own forces to Eorzea. If you would have us.
We harbored no expectations of such generous aid, and as there is no telling when the Empire might strike back at you, would it not be wiser to concentrate your resources on the defense of Doma?
I had a mind to pursue a more aggressive defense. To wit, we will send forth shinobi to provinces far and wide to spread word of our victory, that we might inspire others to take up arms as we did. Even the Empire has its limits. If the Garleans cannot be certain where and when the next rebellion will take place, how can they commit another force to Doma? And besides, So long as this debt remains unpaid, how am I to face myself and Gorsitzer?
As you wish. I will relay your offer to the Eorzean Alliance.
All of Doma is counting on you to finish what we have started. You have it in you, Lys, to seize the future you want. Never forget.
I won't, Hien. Not your words or anything else. Everything that led us here, that will drive us forward, I'll carry it with me always. And that's a promise.
I will hold you to that. Go with them to Eorzea. Tell their people of our triumph and of our pledge to stand with them.
By your leave, I shall pave the way for our new alliance.
Hurry up, you lot! The ship's about to weigh anchor!
It seems our time is at an end. Go well, my friends, and may we meet again beneath a western sky.
Meanwhile, in the royal palace of Alamigo.
I always knew that woman was unfit for command.
Aye, when you think of all the resources we poured into that hole, and for what?
Beast yet lives. Mayhap it is time I sharpen my claws. I wonder, will you walk into my parlor once more?
For Dolorem Lupus, come at the command of the Lord Viceroy to present the prisoner taken by the Cranier Lupi.
No.
Xenosia Galvus, I presume. It's true what they say. You do have the eyes of a monster. A ravenous, insatiable fiend.
You, give the butcher your weapon.
Yes, my lord.
My lord, this is...
A reward given in recognition of your service. I trust it will prove more capable than its former owner.
I swear, I'll not disappoint you, my lord.
Good. Now, silence that mewling little piglet. I would not hear another sound pass her lips. Until I strip the fat from her.
Oh, Kryle!
Back in Eorzea at last, ready to pick up where we left off and finish the fight. We're not who we were when we left. We're stronger and wiser. But let's do it. Let's get back to Alamigo and defeat Xenos once and for all. Yep, I'm sure we will. Catch me if you can. The Returned. Okay. While you were away. Here we are, home at last. I must say, the journey passed more quickly than I had expected. That would be due to the absence of otherworldly interference, I expect. I should be glad if we did not speak of that unpleasantness again. But in spite of all that and more, we returned better for the experience, and more importantly, triumphant. Indeed, and with Doma freed of imperial oppression, it is only right that we turn our thoughts to the plight of Alamigo. Well, I'm all for that, obviously, but I think you should go and see the refugees at Revenant's Toll before doing anything else. They'll be thrilled to hear what we've accomplished, and it'd sound best coming from you. Thank you. I shall do as you suggest. I see I am not too late. Admiral, what are you doing here? The East Ardenar Trading Company informed me of your impending arrival. I have tidings I thought best to share with you in person. From Garabania? Aye. The Alliance still holds the wall, despite several Imperial counterattacks. But we have been unable to press further into occupied territory. Commander Kemp and his men, meanwhile, have made great strides towards rebuilding their depleted ranks. They have even taken it upon themselves to attempt some few operations. With mixed results, I am sorry to say. It was a complication arising from one such venture which moved me to seek you out. During a mission to transport wounded resistance fighters to the Rising Stones, Kryle Baldessian was taken prisoner.
Kryle? Do they know where she's being held?
They do not, but your comrades were informed at once, and I am told Thancred is in Garabania looking for her as we speak.
How could this have happened? We must seek out Thancred without delay.
Nay, Kryle taught me better than that. It would be unwise to act without first acquiring a full understanding of the situation. Thank you for informing us. Tired though we may be, we must make haste to Castrum Oriens. Pray excuse us, Admiral. Lady Yugiri. Oh, no. Whoa. Castrum Oriens, go! There you are. You have heard the news. In broad strokes from Admiral Bloofsvin, what happened? Kryle and a squadron of resistance fighters were escorting Yashtola and several other wounded to the Rising Stones for further treatment when they were ambushed by Imperial forces. Arnvald and his men fought valiantly, but in the chaos. I will make no excuses. We failed to protect her.
Do not be so hard on yourself. You protected Yashtola and the others, did you not?
Tell us about the attack.
It was the Skulls. They knew a path across the wall we hadn't found. We thought we were safe once we reached the Black Shroud. Ugh, we weren't expecting an ambush. During the fight, I caught a glimpse of their leader's memories. It was all planned. The advantage of having a walker in the field. I'm not as strong in the Echo as Mang is, of course. Half the time it's enough to knock me on my arse, like I've taken a dose of concentrated ether. So you walked in Fordola's memories. What did you see? A woman promised the world. Education, training, citizenship. All that and more if she but sold her soul. A traitor to her people. A pretender to her masters. It was Xenos himself that gave the order. Told her to return with Cryo Baldessian. Alive. Our agents have been carefully monitoring Imperial communications since the attack, but have yet to intercept any transmissions making reference to Kryle or her current whereabouts. If their orders were to bring Kryle back alive, we can save her if we move quickly enough. As you say, time is of the essence, which is why I intend to slip past enemy lines and see what information I can uncover on my own. In the meantime, it's up to you and our allies to command the Imperial's undivided attention. Lots of shouting and explosions and so forth. Keep them distracted, and I'll find her. Very well. I wish I could do more to aid you, but I understand. Commander Kemp is on his way to the castrum as we speak for a meeting with General Alden. If you hurry, you can find him on the road and discuss the situation beforehand. I think Mang and I are going to go and see Conrad like he suggested. You all wait here. Yeah. Yeah, back to this. Back to this shit. Conrad.
Well, well, isn't this a pleasant surprise? It fills my heart with joy to see you two hale and healthy.
Welcome home, Lys, Mang. I'm sure you've heard about Kryle by now. That's why we're here. I'm still not sure what to think about it, but we'll save her. We'll definitely save her somehow.
I have no doubt that you will. You look stronger for your time in the Far East, lass, and that's good news for Kryle.
I'd like to think so, but enough about me. How's everything with you and the Resistance?
Better than when last you saw us, and no mistake. Arnvald's been a godsend. Him and Minago and all the other Youngbloods have achieved so much in such a short time. We've been blessed to receive the support of the Flames Alamegan Brigade, who've been instrumental in freeing our countrymen from labor camps throughout Garabania, as well as some political prisoners from the city proper, believe it or not. Together with the refugees returning from Ulda and elsewhere, we've had no shortage of able-bodied men and women eager to join the cause.
I knew you wouldn't stop fighting, even after what happened at the Reach.
Force of habit, I suppose. Though we've come a long way, we still have far to go. But we'll fight for every ilm, and sooner or later we'll get to Alamigo. But listen to me prattling on when we should be making haste to Castromorians. There's no point in you telling me everything now when you only have to say it all again for the Flame General's benefit.
You're right. I'll go on ahead and tell the others you're not far off.
Teleport, so I don't have to look at the slow mount speed.
You've spoken with Thancred then. Good. Take heart. If anyone can track her down, it's him. I believe I hear Commander Kemp's party approaching. If you are ready to address Father and the others, let us be about it.
Rolger's Beacon. There you are. And there is Commander Kemp, I see. I know you are eager to speak of our next move, but we would hear first hear more of your last. Tell us of your deeds in Doma.
Okay.
Pray, join me in welcoming our Scion allies, but recently returned from their mission to the Far East. We have been most eager to hear a first-hand account of your time there, eventful as we understand it was.
Very well. Allow me.
Such victories are rarely won without sacrifice, but the prize is worth the price. Doma, free after all these years.
Bloody hells. Flooding their own castle for a better chance at victory. We could learn a thing or two from that lad.
Our agents report a flurry of communications between Garlemald and Alamigo in recent days. 'Tis plain they are in the midst of deliberating their response to the Doman uprising.
Good. Every Imperial unit in occupied territory will be on the lookout for civil unrest. The fear of leaving critical locations undefended will make commanders think twice about committing their forces, giving us a chance to seize the initiative.
We have a chance, aye. Mayhap the last one we're ever going to get. While we've done our best to rebuild the resistance, the Imperials have only increased their efforts to root out sympathizers. If we keep on playing for smaller prizes, it's only a matter of time before they crush us again. And that we won't come back from.
A swift advance seems best for all concerned, not least poor Mistress Kryle.
Then let us waste no more time. The campaign for Alamegan liberation begins now. Our first objective will be to capture Castellum Valladina. Take the bridge, and the whole of the fringes will be ours. From there, we can push east towards the peaks. I name this operation Ralgar's Beacon. For as Ralgar once sent his star to guide our ancestors to these lands, so too shall it see us home.
Yeah, Ralgar.
The success of this operation is paramount. So long as the Empire holds Castellum Valladina, the main host cannot advance. Xenos knows this, which is why he has ordered Fordola and her men to see to the bridge's defense.
So we'll get to fight the Skulls again.
The Butcher is not to be underestimated. She is decisive, ruthless, and feared by foes and friends alike. But we have a plan to defeat her. First, we send an alliance force down the main road, signaling our intention to mount an all-out assault. The garrison will muster their forces and prepare for a protracted battle. However, they will soon find that we are ill-prepared for their counterattack. Our men will begin to break ranks and flee.
I see. Show them your backs and give them a target too tempting not to pursue.
Aye, Fordola is too aggressive not to press the advantage. She will order her men to give chase. We lure them as far as East End, where the commanders will rally their forces and attempt to hold their ground. If all goes to plan, we should be able to keep the greater part of their garrison occupied.
Leaving us to tackle the bridge's remaining defenders. Very clever, I'm sure. But what are we to do if the Imperials smell a rat and return before we've taken the place?
I don't need you to take Valladina, Commander Kemp. All I need is for you to fly your flag from its tower.
You mean to trick them into believing that the bridge has fallen?
Aye. We convince them Valladina is lost, hit them hard with our reinforcements, and watch them go running for the hills. Then, when the dust is settled, we regroup at the Castellum. What say you?
It's a bold plan, but a good one. We'll do it. In that case, we shall support both the Resistance and the Alliance forces. Mang, Lys, Arnvald, I ask that you accompany Commander Kemp, Alize and I will remain with the Flame General.
We will return to Volger's Reach and make our preparations. As soon as they are complete, we will join you in the field. Godspeed.
Alright, we're getting, getting into it. Right into it. Yep.
In case you haven't noticed, the flag flying above Veladina is bloody massive. It'd take a dozen men to change it, and far too long besides. But there's no need for all that, right, Minago?
Not so long as I have my griffin and a satchel of glamour prisms, no.
Arnvald, you're in charge of the runners between us and the Alliance. No link pearls. Lise, I want you to look in on the squadrons. Make sure they've got everything they need. Everybody clear?
Aye, sir.
All forces are to depart for Castellum Corvi when ready. That will be all. Mang, stay with me a moment, if you would. There's a few men I'd like you to look in on personally. Each of them has lost people, and I can tell that it weighs on their hearts. There have been a lot of new faces since last you were here, so it's best if I just tell you where to look. One's an officer you'll find in the barber. Another's an older fellow who likes to pass the time on the shore of Starfall. The last is a fiery young lad from Little Alamigo, who I'm told trains by himself by the river to the fringes. You'll know them when you see them. Come and find me when you're finished.
No... Okay, I'm gonna actually attune to this bullshit. Although it doesn't look like that'll actually save any time. Maybe. Oh, I should mount up. That would be a good idea. Wait, I know you. Lieutenant Mang of the Maelstrom. It is an honor to meet you. I was living hand-to-mouth in Ulda, but decided to enlist in the Flames after I heard tales of your daring do. And now, as fate would have it, I've been sent here to join in the fight for my homeland's liberation. Ah, but this is no time to talk. I've got to prepare for the operation. Take care, Lieutenant. We'll give those Imperial whore sons what for. I say, if it isn't the lad who helped me find the ward I misplaced. Ah, but there I go again, treating you as an equal. It wasn't until after you'd gone that one of my comrades pulled me aside and told me it was only the bleeding hero of Eorzea who'd taken time out of his busy day to help me. Well, what's done is done. But I know that I will fight with every ounce of my strength in this coming battle. And the next, and the next. Mayhap that will serve to repay the favor. Fare you well. Mang, am I right? I doubt you remember me, but I'll never forget you. Saved my life in Little Alamigo, you did. Wilred and the rest of us had gotten into our heads that if we had enough crystals, we could summon Rolliger like the Imalja summoned their god. Thankfully, you put a stop to it. Ever hear about what happened to Wilred? Joined the Braves when they came calling, only to turn up dead one day. Never found out how or why, but I reckon it doesn't matter. Dead's dead, after all. But at least he died doing what he thought was right. And maybe that's the best folks like us can hope for, eh? Not that I'm in a hurry. Any hurry, mind. Dude, imagine if we had to fucking fight Rolger. Oh my god. That would be like a level 200 raid boss. Alright, I'm just assuming this is gonna be faster. Slightly. You've had word with the men I mentioned then. As I'm sure you noticed, they've another thing in common aside from tragedy. You've touched each of their lives in one way or another, but that's not the reason I wanted you to speak with them. A man who's lived in Garabania his entire life, who bore witness to the realities of the occupation for 20 unbroken years. A man who fled El Amigo in search of a new life, who swore to serve another nation, only for fate to conspire to send him back here. A youth born on foreign soil, who never knew his parents' homeland, yet nevertheless felt kinship with our cause. Three men, three stories, three reasons, yet all belong to the resistance. In growing larger, we've grown more diverse, and while there is good in that, there's also the potential for strife and discord. It'd take a special sort to lead such men to El Amigo, don't you think? Good thing they've got you. For now, aye, but not forever. And to be frank, I don't always know what to say to the ones who left, not to mention the youths. Nay, the resistance needs a leader with a wider view. Someone who's not lived their whole life in Garabania, who's known death and hardship but not been ground down by them. Aye, as you may have guessed, I've been thinking of asking Lys, but it'll be her decision in the end. I trust I needn't say that this conversation is just between you and me. Good lad. Right then. We'd best head to Castellum Corvi, or what remains of it, rather. Was it really worth delaying our trip just so I could talk to those assholes? I think it's... No, not the Hawthorne Hut. Oh, God. I think it's probably faster to just go here. Alright, I guess I'll pause. Alright. We'll lead the way while the other units launch their own separate attacks. Remember that we need to hold out until Monago sees to the flag. Got your gear in order? Any moment now. Do it.
It's begun, then.
Good. It's the waiting that drives me mad. Standing around, knowing what's to come. I'll never get used to it.
Calm down, Nago. You're making her nervous. We've come this far, haven't we? We just need to make it the rest of the way.
Right.
Looks like the bastards went for the bait. The bridge is ours for the taking. Now remember, Monago, I want you to make for the tower as soon as you see an opening and get that flag flying. We'll see to the fighting.
I won't let you down, sir.
Come then. Rolga's star shall burn bright this day.
Just random fucking snake woman. It freaks me the fuck out. Alrighty. Oh no, they saw us, but they're not warning the others.
Here it comes!
Oh, actually, this design of Magitek armor is much more what I expected compared to what we have. I'd love to be able to get that version as a mount. To the bridge. One of these, and one of these, one of these. For flare. How? And do one of these.
Take this!
Yeah, I feel like the setting in the audio settings is just like dialogue volume or something. That's just for like when they say something in combat and it's super fucking loud compared to everything else. I don't know if you can really adjust cutscene volume. Player. Think you're clever with all your little tricks? Think again. None of you are leaving here alive. Okay. Silver flare there. How you like that? How you like that? Think that bothers me? Don't bother me. I can cure myself.
for flair. I don't even need to cure myself. You ain't got shit on me.
Meet my new friend!
What does that mean? You're dead?
God damn you! No more running! No more hiding! Let's finish this! Look! The flag!
The bridge is ours! Alamigo! 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 Yeah!
Stand your ground! It's not over yet! Damn it!
Let them go, Lise. We've done what we came here to do. That's enough for now.
Damn, dude.
Philodina is fallen? Impossible!
We have them on the run! Forward! No mercy!
Regroup! Regroup! We have to regroup! All units, fall back!
Commander, the fourth cohort has been routed. We'll be at the mercy of the enemy's reinforcements if we don't fall back now.
Idiot! We have the stronger force by far. Don't be taken in by their tricks. Or would you rather tell Xenos you lost to this rabble?
No, but if the snakes betray us in the confusion, we'll have no way out. I'm begging you, Commander. Give the order or we'll all die here.
As common traitors who drank of muddied waters, for all the good it did us. Schools with me! The day is theirs, and so is this bastard bridge. Someone bring the snake. suppose. It's our first victory, isn't it? And that has to be worth something.
Okay. It's a shame Fordola got away, but we did what we came here to do. I have to remind myself it's just the first step, but it's a big one. We're gonna take it back, all of it. One ilm at a time if we have to. Alright, one more. Fortunes of War.
There's still a chance that some Imperials are holed up inside the Castellum. We'll need to search it top to bottom to be sure it's safe. In the meantime, I want you to rendezvous with the main host. Keep your weapons at the ready. There's a chance you might come face to face with soldiers on the run en route. On second thought, it might be prudent for you to do a preemptive sweep of the region for soldiers that have gone to ground. We shouldn't afford them any time to regroup and launch a counterattack. When you've judged your work to be done, report to General Alden in Bittermill.
The tortoise will take me where I need to go. Some big ass things. Burrow antlion. I don't want anything to do with that. So I finally discovered that I can adjust the volume of my headphones without adjusting, like, the PC sound. Because it was always, like, the sound coming into my headphones was always, like, blaring for almost anything. But the sound going into OBS never seemed that crazy. And I didn't want to turn down the audio, because otherwise it would be too quiet for the recording. Until I finally looked over at my my preamp or whatever, where my headphones are connected, and saw that the knob for the headphones was cranked up pretty damn high. So now, that's why I would often be like shouting in the midst of really intense parts, just so I can hear myself. It's all good now. Do you like Red Mage? This is definitely one of my favorite jobs. Could end up being my main.
Well met. All's well at the bridge. Good, good. The fighting has died down here too, as you can see. Pippin left but a moment ago with a contingent of troops to occupy Veladina. If and when the Imperials return, they'll find us dug in behind their own walls.
I could not have hoped for a better outcome, General. Splendidly done.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. It'll take more than one Castellum to turn the tide. My men and I will deal with the remaining enemy forces. Scions, I bid you return to Commander Kemp and his men.
Delight not over much in victory, not when there are battles left to fight. Our work here is finished. Our resistance allies are waiting.
That's the problem when you get, like, the single battle fates like this, the big enemies.
It just takes fucking forever. Like, I stopped in by one on my own a while back. And I was, like, hitting it. I hit it for, like, a minute or maybe two. But I took aggro and I was about to die. So I was like, fuck this. And I ran away. Like, 10 minutes later or something. It was, like, maybe more than that. I was off in another part of the region. And suddenly it popped up that I got a silver medal for it. It's just like, oh, my God. I felt like I had done so much after I had ran away from that fight. If I had just stayed there till the end just to get the gold. Ugh. I don't know why those people stuck through it, but I guess.
Back so soon. I suppose the general and his men had matters well in hand. The vice marshal and his men showed up not long after you left. If the gods are good, there'll be no one left to fight.
You have to keep leveling. Alright. So, that's good. Next time, we will definitely be doing a trial. I have no idea what we're going to be fighting. That's coming out of left field. I'm pretty sure it's not Xenos. So, unless Fordola gets really amped up, I don't know. I don't know what it'll be. But, and then after that trial, I would say we're in the sort of the home stretch for Stormblood. So, yeah. Alrighty. My name is Mang. Game watching has been Final Fantasy XIV. See you fine folks in the next part.